Sure. Anish Srivastava is with us. He's, of course, Chief Investment Officer at IDBI Fortis Life Insurance Company. Anish, afternoon. Thanks for joining us. Prashant here. As a money manager, what do you make of this up move for this, relative strength vis-a-vis a couple of other emerging markets, Asian markets, any market you want to compare? India is now pretty much the front of the pack.
Right. One of the reasons is that most of the funds in India were sitting on large cash. And so is the case with the global funds when they were reasonably underweight on India. So once this up move has started, most of the funds have this left out kind of a feeling and a lot of money is getting into the markets.
Are you also starting to put your money back into the market, money back to work? What have you been doing? Can you just illustrate that?
Our strategy has been that we were defensive up to valuation levels, and once we got the comfort of the valuation and once we studied some of the lead indicators, we realized that there is a possibility of an uptick in the market. And sensing that, we had been substantially invested. We had a strategy of having up to 20-25% of investment in cash, which we deployed, and as of now we are running a portfolio up to 95% invested in 5% cash.
Anish, hi, Namrata also joining in. So this is ahead of elections, because I'm just trying to get a sense of this. Most fund managers out there are saying, we don't want to be 95% long or really hugely bullish just ahead of elections.
Well, election is something which is an event risk and it's very difficult to preempt. My sense is that if global markets would keep performing the way they are, then Indian markets would follow the suit. Valuations were attractive. There are certain risks, there are certain uncertainties, but it's very difficult to play out. If there is no clear mandate to any of the government, any of the parties, then there would be an issue. And yes, there's a reason why perhaps upside would remain capped in the markets.
Anish, has institutional activity come in on a genuine basis? Is this like a proper commitment? Because, the market is still confused whether it's all generated because of short covering, hugely oversold positions, then getting reversed, some amount of short squeeze, and that's sustaining it. Do you believe that over, especially yesterday's trading session, when we as India outperformed the rest of the world, do you believe there is a shift happening with the domestic fundamentals of India now coming more into prominence?
Well, that is something is very difficult to say, but my sense is that when monetary policy is loose, so much of money is floating around, there is always a possibility that there would be expansion of price earning multiples, and that is what is happening and that is what we are seeing. If you ask me, there can be three kind of scenarios. No, best case scenario is when there would be expansion of multiples and when there would be a growth in earnings of the corporates. Worst case scenario is when there would be a degrowth in earnings as well as there would be a contraction in multiples. And what we believe as of now is that a realistic scenario, which as per our assumption is that there would be a degrowth in earnings, but at the same time there would be expansion of multiples, as I said, because of low interest rates globally, efforts made to infuse additional liquidity in the markets, and at the same time some kind of a risk appetite returning. How do we read that the risk appetite running is, like, you see what is happening to gold. Gold has corrected from say $1,000 to today less than $900. Similarly, you see that what has happened to TED spreads. TED spreads have come down substantially. Some other leading indicators like metal index. Metal index has started moving up. Freight rates have started moving up. So some kind of stability is perceived. So considering that, we can say that these lead indicators are giving us an indication that perhaps risk appetite is there. But if you look at industrial production numbers, if you look at consumption numbers, if you look at credit growth numbers, all these are still, although these are basically lag indicators, and since one should not really read too much into it. Going forward, we still believe that macroeconomic problems would still hurt corporate profit growth. There is a possibility that there will be 5% kind of a degrowth in earnings in FY10. So best scenario is degrowth in earnings and expansion of multiples. For me, best case scenario would be perhaps 12 times multiple. If we are surprised by a higher than 5% kind of a degrowth, then perhaps market would correct further down. But otherwise, it should ideally remain between 9,000 to 10,500 range.
All right, Anish. Fair point there. Good speaking with you and getting your thoughts across this afternoon here on Profit. Take a quick break as well.